This is the first theoretical lecture of the week that starts in 10 of May, and this lecture is related with duality. So we are going to present the concept of shadow prices, the concept of reduced costs, and we are going to illustrate how to obtain the solution of a linear programming problem using the dual formulation. So, we are going to start by illustrating the concept of shadow prices, and we are going to use the problem of the tapestry company, which we present here again, and we also have here the final table, that is the optimal table of the simplex. So, we have here the final basic variables, x1 and x2, and the non-basic variables S1 and S2 that we are going to consider equal to zero to extract the solution that we have here. We are going to analyze also the optimality of the solution. So we are going to consider the line of C. And in particular, we are going to look to these coefficients. So, in terms of the solution, we know that we need to consider the non-basic variables equal to zero in order to extract the value of z and the value of the basic variables. In terms of the optimality, we go to the line of z, and we can extract the new configuration of the objective function. So we have here the coefficients that we extract from the table related with S1 and S2, which are the non-basic variables. And of course, we can rewrite this equation so that we can express z as a function of the non-basic variables. Now, when we look to this expression, we can extract, for example, this conclusion, that is, the partial derivative of z in order S1 is a negative one. And we are considering S1 equal to zero to obtain this solution. So we see that if we change this condition, it's possible only through this way. And because this is less than zero, that is, z will decrease. So we conclude that we cannot change any of these conclusions. So this is the optimal solution. Now, we are going to use the partial derivatives to illustrate the concept of shadow prices. So we can evaluate a variation of z using a variation of the slack variable. That variation, if for example, if the variation of the slack variable is 1, we can use this expression to obtain the variation of z. It will be this amount, that is, it will decrease by 65 divided by 11. Now, we can assign a meaning to this result, that is, a variation of a positive variation of a slack variable means that we will use 1 unit less of the resource. Now, if we assign this meaning to a positive variation of the slack variable, we must assign the opposite to a negative variation of the slack variable. That is, if we consider a negative variation of the slack variable, we can assume that we are planning to have an additional unit of the resource. And in that case, if we consider the variation of slack variable equal to -1, we get the positive variation of the objective function, which is given by 65 divided by 11. So this number is the shadow price, which we represent in this case shadow price of resource number 1 by y1, because it represents what I can earn if I can increase the availability of resource number one by one unit. So it also represents the opportunity cost of increasing the availability of resource number one by one unit. And the opportunity cost is essentially what I'm losing for not increasing the availability of the resource. So we get the shadow price of resource number one, and doing the same analysis, we can get also the shadow price of resource number two. So let's look now to the dual formulation, which we are going to present in the context of a typical production problem. In this case, the objective is clear. It is to minimize the total opportunity cost of the resources used in the production. So essentially, we want to minimize the possibilities of using the resource inefficiently. So the decision variables in this case are the shadow prices, because the shadow prices are the marginal opportunity costs of using the resource, that in our problem are the availability of the machines. And in terms of the restrictions, we want to ensure that we are in a situation of production, even that we are using the resource inefficiently, because this is how we characterize the solution domain. The solution domain has in its middle the inefficient points, and in the boundary the efficient ones. Now, since we already identified the objective and we have the characterized the decision variables, we can start by writing the problem, and we are going to start with the objective function. So we have in this table the data related with the problem that we are solving, and we have two products, product one and product two. We know the contribution margins of each product, so 40 euros per unit and 30 euros per unit. And we have two resources, two machines, machine one or resource one and resource two. They are available on the first one 12 hours a day and second one 14 hours a day. To produce one unit of product one, we need 3 hours of the first resource and 7 hours of the second, while in P2 we need 4 and 2. So to each resource, we are going to associate a shadow price. So for resource number one, we have Y1, and for resource number two, we have Y2. So the objective function is the total opportunity cost. So the opportunity cost of resource number one is 12 Y1. So we have 12 Y1 for the contribution of resource number one, and for resource number two, we have 14 Y2. And so this is the total opportunity cost. That is, this is what I'm going to lose if I decide not to use the resources. Let's consider now the restrictions. So to write the restrictions, we need to assign a meaning. And the meaning is the value of the resources, or the value that we can get with the resources that we are going to use to produce one unit of a given product, must be greater or equal than the benefit provided by that product, which is the contribution margin of that product. Of course, that here we include both inefficient points and efficient points. The inefficient points corresponds to the case in which the value of the resources, that is, the value that resources can provide, is higher than the value that we can get. And while the efficient way corresponds to, into the case that the value of the resources is equal to the value of the contribution margin. Now, let's consider, for example, the first product. The resources used is 3 hours of the first one and 7 hours of the second. And the value of each unit is Y1 for the first one and Y2 for the second one. So this is what we get for the value of the resources. And of course, the contribution margin is 40. So must be greater or equal than 40. So in the case of the second product, we have these resources that we need, the values. So we get, this is the values the value of the resources necessary to produce one unit, and this is what we can get with that the production of one unit of product 2. So these are our restrictions. So we can now present the dual formulation. So we have the objective function, this is the total cost, total opportunity cost of the resources, which we want to minimize, subject to the conditions. We have two conditions, one for product 1 and another for product 2, which are conditions of the type greater or equal, and of course these are positive quantities. We can solve this problem using the graphical solution. So we have the two restrictions represented in blue for product 1 and in red for product 2, and this is the solution domain, that is, and we want to minimize the opportunity costs. So that is, we want to minimize what we lose for not using the resources. So we have here the lines of C in this case, so they have this inclination, so we can start here, and we see that they decrease, these lines, they decrease in this direction. So we are going, we consider different lines until we arrive to this one. So we see through the inclination, we see that the optimal solution is this point, which is the point and in which we have the intersection of the two boundaries. So since we know what is the optimal, we can evaluate it solving this system of equations. And we get, of course, the value of the shadow prices that we saw in the beginning of our lecture. Okay, and with the value of the shadow prices, we can evaluate the total opportunity cost. And we arrive to the conclusion that, in fact, what we can lose by not using the resources is exactly equal to the benefit that we have by producing the products. That is, the solution of the dual formulation is equal to the solution of the primal formulation. Let's consider now the concept of reduced costs. To present the definition of these variables, we are going to consider that we have a linear programming problem represented in this way. That is, we have the objective function as the sum of some coefficients multiplied by the decision variables, and we already have the restrictions transformed in equalities, in which we have here the slack variables. So we can rewrite this problem. For example, the objective function, we put everything in first hand side, and also we do the same here with the restrictions. So we put the independent terms in the first hand side. Now, since this is zero, since this is zero, we can multiply this quantity by the shadow prices, and we can add then, so each restriction is multiplied by the associated shadow price, and then we add all the restrictions, so we add all of them, and of course, since this is equal for each of the restrictions, when we sum the result for all of them, we still have a zero quantity. So if we have a zero quantity, we can add this to the expression of the objective function. So when we get this result here. Now we can rearrange these sums here so that we can group this part with this part. So after the rearrangement, we get this expression here, and then we can now put something in the second hand side. So this part here is the reduced cost of product J, as we will analyze in more detail in the next slide. So this is what we extract from the previous slide, the definition of the reduced costs, and we can see that it corresponds to the coefficients of the decision variables, which in a production problem corresponds to the quantities of the products produced. Now, we see that the definition involves two terms. The first term, which in fact corresponds to the value of the resources used to produce one unit of a product, which we already saw in the definition of the dual formulation. And of course, these coefficients that we have here correspond to the contribution margin of the product. So essentially, the reduced cost is the difference between the value of the resource used and the contribution margin. And of course, that in we saw that when we solve this kind of problems, and if we look to the line of Z, we can conclude that the products that in fact are produced, their quantities are basic variables, so the reduced cost is zero, which means that the products that in fact we produce obey to this relation. That is, the value that resources used can provide is equal to the value that we get with the production. In the non-basic cases, is the opposite. That is, if a given product is not produced, the variable associated to the quantity is a non-basic one, and means that we have a positive coefficient in the line of Z. That is, we have this situation, the value of the resources necessary to produce one unit of that product are higher than the benefit that that product can provide us. That's why we don't produce it. Let's consider now the solution from the dual. We are going to illustrate this with an example that involves a typical production problem with three products and two resources. So the first thing that we need to do is to write the dual formulation. To do that, we start with the objective function. So we have the availability of the resources, and to each resource we are going to associate a shadow price. So the opportunity cost of the availability of the first resources is simply the availability multiplied by the shadow price. So the availability of the second resource is in this case 400 units, and the shadow price is Y2. So we have here the opportunity cost of resource number one and total opportunity cost of resource number two. So this is the objective function which we want to minimize. Now, in terms of the restrictions, we need to consider three, because we have three products. So, and the restrictions are of the type value of the resource used greater or equal than the contribution margin. So the resource used to produce product one is 5 and 6. The opportunity costs are per unit are Y1 and Y2. So this is what we have for product one, the 5 and multiply Y1 and 6 multiply Y2. And the contribution margin is 50. So, and the same for the other for the other products. So what we can see here is that in this case we have a problem with three decision variables. That is, we cannot solve it using the graphical method, but the dual problem involves only two decision variables. That is, we can solve it using the graphical method. To obtain the solution of the dual formulation using the graphical method, we need to identify first the solution domain. So we start, for example, with the restriction of product one, and the boundary is this line here representing blue. That is, it defines this region there. And when we consider, for example, the restriction of product 2, it's represented here, the boundary is represented here by this line in green, so it represents this region there. And for product 3, similar. So the intersection between these three sets gives this part here. Okay, so we need to consider only product 2 and product 3. So this boundary is outside the solution domain. Now, if we consider also the lines of the total cost, the ISO lines of total cost, we can see that they have this inclination. So when we consider several of them, we can see that this is the one that still has a point in the solution domain, but the one that has the minimum value. So we can conclude that this is the optimal point, which involves this line in brown and the horizontal line. So the line in green is not involved because it intersects the horizontal line here on the left of this point. So we can consider that we can extract the solution immediately because we can see that Y2 must be 0 and Y1 is given from the third restriction. That is, we can go here and we can see that if we consider Y2 0, we get Y1. If this is equal, it's equal to 80 divided by 6. So this is what we have here. So we have here the solution. And with the shadow prices, we can extract the total opportunity cost of the resources. So this is the solution of the dual problem. So let's see how can we extract the solution of the first problem, that is the primal problem. We are going to analyze first the meaning of the meaning that we can extract, or the consequences that we can extract from the values of the shadow prices. For example, shadow price number 2 is 0. What that means? It means that we will not profit from increasing the availability of this resource. This means that this resource, we have excess of this resource, and increasing the availability will make only the excess greater. So we cannot profit from that. So that means that slack variable of resource number 2 must be equal to 0. Now, relatively to the first resource, we see that shadow price is greater than 0. That means that this resource is used at full capacity. So this means that if we can have more, we can profit more. That's why it's greater than 0. So that means that slack variable of resource number 1 must be equal to 0. And now we are going to look to the restrictions related with the products. So in the left side here, we have the value of the resource used. And in the right side, we have the contribution margin. Now, since the shadow price number 2 is 0, we don't need to consider this part here. So, for example, the value of resource used to produce product 1 is 5y1. So 5 and y1 is 13.33. That is, we get 66.67. It's greater than 50. That is, it does not compensate to produce this product because the values of the resources involved can provide us this value here if used elsewhere. So we are not going to use them here, because here, if we use them here, we get only this benefit. So consequence is that x1 must be 0. Now, if we do the same for resource number 2, we get 8 that multiplies 1333. It's 106.67, greater than 100. Again, we are not going to produce this product. The value of resource used in product 3 are equal to 80. 80 is the benefit that the production of one unit provides. So we are going to produce this product. X3 is greater than 0. Now, with these conditions, we can simplify our restrictions in problem number 1 to obtain this result here, from which we can extract immediately X3 and S2 and the value of Z, which of course is exactly equal to the value that we get previously, that is the opportunity cost of the resources. And this is it. This is the solution of the primal problem. And it's also the end of this lecture. Thank you for your attention and see you in the next one.